Hello and welcome to part 3 of creating trendy neon 80s graphics with Sapphire. My name is Ben Brownlee from Boris Effects, and in part 3 we're going to be building up a bit more of our world. So we're going to take that electric floor that we created in exercise 2 and start to build a world around it. So let's have a look at how we get started with that. All right, here is where we left off in part 2 with our animated floor. In part 3, we're going to start filling out our background a little bit more and creating our world up. So without any further ado, let's do that. I'm going to make a new composition. I will call this one Neon World. And 1920 by 1080, 25 frames a second, 8 seconds long. And with our new comp, let's put something in it. Create a new solid, which is going to be our background color. We're going to have just like a straight background color. Yes, I am spelling color with a U. If you don't like it, you can drop the U when you're following along. And let's just make a nice dark purple. Okay, that's definitely purple, but it's not dark enough. Let's go to our solid settings. And we'll just drop the brightness on that. Brightens around about 9. I think that should be nice. Really sort of dark plum. I might even come back and adjust that later as well. Okay, let's add in our animated grid, which is our animated floor background. Stick that over the top. And just so you can see what it's going to look like, let's set this to add. Yeah, that's looking nice. I'm going to turn off the blur in it though. Big, beautiful glow. There we go, just so we can sort of see how that's going to work without our glow. I'm liking that. I really like that smear. So, but that's by the by. Let's focus now, Ben, and focus on getting our cloud sorted out. So I'm going to create another solid layer up here, and let's have this just pure black. And I will call this one Animated Clouds. And hit OK. And let's mask this now so that it will only be able to see down to the horizon. So I'll come into my rectangle tool and click and drag a mask over till we hit the horizon, which is around about there, I would say. Turn off the overlays. Yep, that's looking good. Perfect. Let's turn the grid off now. We don't need to worry about that. And it'll speed everything up a bit more. And come into Sapphire Render. And we're going to render out some of the clouds. Now we've got quite a few different types of clouds to choose from. And I'm just going to start off with clouds multicolor. And let's start to tweak this up a little bit, shall we? Okay, so for the color itself, I'm going to find another purple. Bit of a brighter purple here. Something around about there. Yeah, that should do fine. And for my color noise color, I will do another purple. That's a bit brighter, a bit more sort of magenta rather than a purple. Can always change up things like the brightness later as I need to, but I'm happy keeping this quite nice and bright when we're starting to work on it. Now, most of this stuff I'm going to keep at default. And if I play this through, you could already see that our clouds are animating over time and obviously animating from left to right. Now, I don't want them to actually move left to right at all. So I'm going to go to my Shift Speed X. Just turn that off. Now if I play that back, we've just got some static clouds. We can get these boiling up a little bit more. So change the boil speed, and that will animate things up a little bit more. But we really don't have to do too much with these default values, because what I want to happen is for these to look like they're coming towards us. So it's that whole thing of looking like it's 3D space without using any sort of 3D effects. And the way to do that with clouds is just to very easily animate up this frequency here. And this is one of those ones that I'm probably not going to control with expressions. Come to the start with a frequency of about 4 and then go to the end with a frequency of, we set that to 2.3. I actually think we can go even lower with this. Maybe 1.5. Let's have a look how that works. And that's starting to move menacingly forward. Yeah, not too fast, not too slow. I like that. I think that's gonna be all right. And that's it done for the clouds. Let's come in and make the sun now. I'm going to use another shape. I'm just going to use the ellipse tool and fill us with... Actually, it doesn't really matter what I fill us with because I'm going to change this up anyway. But let's make this a yellow-ish color. And just come and click and... Ooh, that's... Doesn't look like a ellipse at all. That's like a polygon. Ellipse tool. There we go. Bring that in. Hold down the shift key. And make a big, big sun there. And I can shift that around into relatively the right position. And I want it to be, yeah, about halfway up when we hit the horizon. So now I can copy my mask from the animated clouds. So Control or Command C and Control or Command V. And now I have my sun. Close all this other stuff up. So let's make up this effect that we have in the original here with the stripes in the sun, the sort of Venetian blind effect. And to do that, I'm going to come into effects and into my Sapphire transitions and do wipe stripes. And let's just tweak these up a little bit. So the first thing to do is come in and add in a bit of a wipe percentage so we can see what these stripes are doing. So it's going to just be transitioning our image on and off using stripes. Obviously, we're not going to be animating this, so I could just find a percentage that I like. 64 is fine. Take my angle to 0. Nope. Take my angle to 90 to have it horizontal. And now I can come in and start to tweak up the frequency. And so the higher the frequency, obviously, the more stripes that we have. And I'm going to keep, yeah, actually take quite a high frequency, maybe 75-ish. That'll do. And I can add a little bit of softness to my edges, maybe one or two. I don't want to add too much softness. I can even shift my stripes up and down a bit, because if you have a look, when that's set to 0, we've got just a tiny little stripe poking out there, which irks my eye just a little bit. So I'm just going to shift my stripes a tiny wee bit. Cool. So let's colorize our sun. I want to make it really easy to come in and tweak the colors later, so I don't want to have a window open. I'm going to use another effect here. I'm going to Sapphire Render, S, Gradient, Radial. And this gives me a radial gradient coming from my center here, which I can now move up. And I can change, actually using the widgets here, I can change the width that we have. So I'll probably place that roundabout in the center and then just stretch that out so that it fills up my sun. And I can choose a couple of colors. So I'm going to have a bright yellow, a little bit desaturated maybe, but bright yellow in the center. And the outer one, the outer edge, is going to go a little bit more towards the orange, I think. Maybe around about there. We can tweak this up as we start to put other effects over the top of it. I can even change up the outer radius if I want to come in and just tweak this a little bit here. Yeah, I kind of like that. It's looking all right. Now, as before, we're going to add in our big, beautiful glow over the top of everything here. So I'm going to copy that from my animated floor, paste that into my world, Control or Command C, Control or Command V, turn that on there, and see if we need to tweak anything up. I can maybe come into my clouds and take the brightness of those clouds down, just so we're not glowing everything out too much. But that's cool. Yeah, I'm liking that so far. Let's turn on the grid now, our animated floor background. That is starting to look pretty bold. What I might do is come to my background color now and actually change that up. So with the background color selected, I'm going to go to solid settings, come in here, make it darker, maybe make it even more purpley, sort of a little bit more towards the blue even. Oh yeah, I'm liking that. Hit okay. All right, and let's take a little RAM preview of that, see how that's looking. But I can already see that, as I said in the previous exercise, that we're going to need to add something else onto that grid just to kind of hold it together a little bit, pull it together. What's happening at the moment is because those triangle shapes are always animating all the time, especially when all these shapes disappear, it can be quite easy to lose sort of track of what's happening on the ground plane. So I'm going to come in and tweak that up a little bit with another grid. So let's come all the way back to our electric tile. And this is where we need to add in our grid. It's also the reason that I work with pre-comps, so that at any point I can easily come back and make a quick sort of change to this without having to render everything back up again. So let's create up a new solid. And this one is going to be 1080 by 1080. Make that the comp size, make it black, and hit OK. And I will call this black solid, actually. I will call this one grid. Move it down to the bottom of the stack. Back into effects, back to Sapphire render, and S grid. We can't see anything. Why is that? Obviously, we've got our bottom triangle now set to normal. So if I set that to screen, we can actually see what's going on. Let's come into our grid again, and we're going to simplify this to a 4x4 grid. So the boxes X and Y, 24 and 16 respectively. Let's turn this to 4 and 4. I can shift my grid over a little bit. And I can even change my major line spacing as well down to 2 so that I have a fatter line going along with the skinnier lines. And maybe now these fat lines are here, I'll reposition that. And maybe I'll shift that a little bit there so it's not quite sitting in the same place. That's looking all right. And now to add some colors over the top of it. So come to effects and come to render. And clouds color smooth. Whoa! Okay, so this is by default, it's going to combine clouds only. In this case, I'm going to go clouds multiply. And so now I have my colors over the top here. I've got too many colors, so I'm going to simplify this out, take the frequency down to around about 2-ish. And I can then come in and maybe scale the colors to a particular area, particular color. And I want to try a cyan. I'm going to find cyan in my shape eyedropper on the scale colors and find a cyan. Something right about there. Actually, it's turned into a bit more of a green than expected. So maybe just cyan there. I think the only thing I'm going to change is the shift speed. Because if we take a little look here, by default, all of our colors are going to be changing over time. That's what the clouds do. The clouds always change over time. And instead of having it so that it moves in X, 480, I'm going to move it so it moves in Y instead. So stick Y to right about 160, just so we get that sort of feeling of rolling colors coming through. So that's going to be quite nice, I think. Actually, let's make more in the X here. Yeah, that's looking a little bit better. Maybe I'll change my major line spacing to 4 there, sort of tweak that up just a little bit. Yeah, so move that over there somewhere. That should be all right. But I want to mask this off so we don't have the grid going over the top of the triangle. I think that looks a bit messy. So I'll come in with my pen tool. I'll turn off Roto Bezier because I just want to go tap, maybe tweak, here we go, and tweak down there, and tweak it up there as well. So we've got a triangle that fits a little bit bigger than the original one we had. Now, because of the way the effects are working, we have to go into the effect and say mask from path, and that will mask everything out. I'm going to go invert the mask on the grid, and on the cloud color smooth, go mask from path 1 again, and invert the mask at the bottom of the effect. So now we have something that looks a little bit like that. So we've got our triangle always sitting on top of our grid there. And that's going to look quite nice. But there's only one way to check to see if it's going to look quite nice, and that's to pop back in to our Neon World comp, our master comp, because everything else will sort of cascade across the rest of that area there. Oh yeah, I forgot. I'm just going to come into the animated floor here and just move our warp tiles over a little bit. Get that one relatively centered as well. That should be good, I think. Yeah, it's looking better. We still need to do things like tweaking up final colors and checking out the glow, but I think that's pretty good for exercise 3. In part 4, we're going to be focusing more on text and how once we've found the text type that we want to work with, we can recycle some of the ideas that we've used in previous exercises to give a sort of a holistic approach to our final footage. And I'll see you again on the other side. If you're enjoying this series so far, be sure to hit the thumbs up button. It really does help out a good deal. If you have any comments, be sure to send them in the comment section below. To download a free trial and check out all the information about Sapphire, then head on over to borisfx.com.